I'm going to look at the last question, March 2019, double word science, physics, higher tier. It's question number 9. I have bits and pieces of this one done just to see if we just make it different. And here's the mind map that we need to know for this one. Now, it's a velocity time graph. So therefore, the velocity is on the y-axis and the time is on the x-axis. The velocity is measured in meters per second. It's also ms to the minus 1, same thing. But velocity time graphs, you can only learn 3 things. It tells you the velocity at a certain time. You read that off the graph using our dear old trusted ruler. The second thing you can tell from the velocity time graph, the slope is the acceleration. Now there are 2 types of slopes. There's a positive slope, and then the other one is the negative slope. They're both, that goes positive, that goes negative. They're both calculated by the rise. The rise is your y over your run. Sometimes it's known as a delta y over delta x. A rise is change in y over run, change in x. So the last thing is the displacement is the area enclosed. Look at the language I'm using. Displacement. The area enclosed. And usually you have to know about a rectangle, length by breadth. Another thing you have to know about the area of a triangle, half by base by perpendicular height. Also in this question, you need to know the definition of a speed. Well, speed's a scalar. And the thing about a scalar is it's magnitude only. Says you, what would I know about magnitude? Well, magnitude is just a fancy word for size. So speed is distance over time. Look, it's distance. Distance is also a scalar. It also asks you for acceleration, and it's the rate of change of velocity. And rate, as far as you're concerned, means divided by time. See there, look, divided by time. And change of velocity is the velocity at the end, tick away. That's what change means. Velocity at the end, tick away the velocity at the start. So there's your change in velocity divided by the time taken. Rate of change of velocity. Acceleration's a vector. So there's two components, size and direction. Size is important. That's the magnitude of it. Remember, that's the language we used over here. And direction. Well, what way is it pointing? Right or left? Positive or negative? Up or down? So, you can write that down. You can take time to learn that. You can practice that. This is called studying. Now let's look at the question. So, state in words how you would calculate the speed and acceleration. And each indicate whether the quantity is a scalar or a vector. So, yeah, what a letter missing. The distance, speed is the distance divided by the time taken is the speed. Speed's a scalar. Learn it. Acceleration is the change in velocity divided by the time taken. Acceleration is a vector. Learn it. Below is a velocity time graph. How do I know it's a velocity time graph? Because it's got velocity here, it's time here. Velocity in meters per second, time in seconds. You can read off the graph using the ruler. The train is at rest once. At rest means it's not moving. It means it has no velocity. When is it no velocity? There, time zero. Calculate the train's acceleration. Look, it accelerates there. So the forces are unbalanced. It goes along there at a constant speed. The forces are in equilibrium or balanced. It decelerates here. The forces are unbalanced. The drag is greater than the force of the engine. Calculate the train's acceleration during the first 4 seconds of its journey. One decimal place. Give your answer correct to one decimal place. You're advised to show you're working out. Acceleration slope is rise over run. Now, look. Take your time. That's 4 seconds. That's 7 meters per second. Be careful. Use the ruler. Look, take your time. No point getting it right and putting the wrong answers in. 7 divided by 4 is 1.75. To one decimal place, 1.8. Now, watch the wording of the question. Remember, the examiner doesn't want to give you marks for anything. Calculate the displacement of the train during the last 6 seconds. The last 6 seconds is from 4 to 10. The last 6 seconds is from 4 to 10. So there's, look at the shapes we have. I want to find that area there. That, all that area. Look, just watch, follow the pencil. All of that. That's what I want to find. Now break it up. There's a rectangle. There's another rectangle. And there's a triangle. So the displacement is area enclosed. So it's a rectangle plus another rectangle plus a triangle. Now be careful. 4 by 6. A 6 by 5. Add on. Now be careful. Take your time. 4 by 2. Plus the triangle. Half the base. Half. There's the base. 2. By 2. 6 5 is 30. Plus 8. Plus 2. 40 metres. 40 metres. Now, just have a wee look at the... Here's the mark scheme. Displacement equals area. 28 by 12. It doesn't really matter what way you split it up. Did you see? Mark. Another mark for the calculation. Mark. 5 marks for that. Fair enough? If you show where you add them all up. Now there's that paper done. So, you should go through every question. You learn from every question. But it takes time to learn. To do a paper right, it takes a couple of hours. You could easily copy the answers out of the mark scheme into the answers and you've it done, but you've learned nothing. You have to practice how to answer the question that the examiner's asking. You have to maybe sit down and learn the mind maps. That's called studying. So when you see a velocity time graph, maybe you should write those three things down. The three things that you need to know. Time. It takes time to learn. Practice. To get the exam mark high, you have to practice what you are going to write down. See you in the next paper. Bye.